which is coming from this jet engine, and also not the noise itself, because if it's only the noise, we can give, provide you by the PPEs, okay? But the other hazard or the other risk generated from this, look at the nozzle. As we said, the nozzle generates thrust. This thrust similar to a cone, convert like this, okay? The cone converts like this, and the exhaust gas temperature generated from this part, it's mentioned here in the specification. If you go to the specification, you will find that I provide you by this table, by the way. I think the exhaust gas temperature equal to how much? Look at this. It's 800 Celsius. 800 Celsius. So we have two things here: hot gas, and we have force, thrust force. So the company or the manufacturer of this device mentioned that if you want to run it, you should keep space 15 meters in this area. 15 meters. It's not allowed to pass from this side. From this point to 15 meters, it should be empty, this space. Because there is a real injury if you stand here in this space, okay? So, first of all, we need the major reason to not run it or to not operate it today, that we have an approval from the health and safety department.
And has this engine ever been run in the afternoon? Have we ever obtained approval to run it in the afternoon?
Today?
Any day in the past.
We will, we asked about approval and we got it, and we will ask for approval for...
So my impression is that because of the safety issues associated with this engine, primarily the noise and the requirement that we need to put a very large empty area, you know, behind this engine. Typically, this has been run only after everyone leaves, correct?
Yeah, at 6 o'clock.
At 6 o'clock. So if we operate this, we would have to ask you to come here at 6 o'clock. So this is inconvenient. Okay, so this is the reason why there is a video of it being operated. And you can refer to that video. And we have gathered here today to just get a more closer look at it and develop some physical idea of what this is. And also to learn about how the measurements are made in this system. I mean, when somebody says measure temperature, then we have an imagination of how temperature is measured, right? Maybe there's somebody sticking the thermometer, correct? But this is not how it is done here. There are electronic sensors, and the measurement is then passed to this data acquisition system, which will send it to the computer. And you can record it in the computer and then access the data later. Yeah. So the important thing here is to become familiar with different parts of this engine and to just have an awareness of how the different sensors are getting the values of fluid properties, correct? Fluid properties, this is what we care about. Mm-hmm. And then understand like why we are measuring them. We are measuring them because we want to understand something about the engine's performance, right? We are doing some calculations. Okay, please continue.
Okay, the last thing I want to mention, that the type we have here, look at down, we have a yellow tank, right? This is to provide the engine by the fuel. The type of the fuel here is the kerosene, the normal kerosene, mixed with a specific kind of oil. It's called aeroshield oil. So you know the kerosene, maybe you used it before. The kerosene, it's a normal fuel, type of a fuel. We mix it with the aeroshield. The function of the aeroshield oil, two. First of all, to make a lubricant for the bearing, because inside this engine, we have a shaft, and the shaft welded with the compressor and the turbine and all movable parts, right? And also we have two bearings to hold on the shaft and connect the shaft with the outer case, right? So this bearing need for lubricant. So the main function of the oil mixed with the fuel is for lubricant, and the second thing, we need coolant for the turbine. The turbine itself needs for coolant because we have a combustion inside the combustion chamber. This combustion, or the temperature of the combustion chamber, the temperature of the combustion chamber reaches to 1000. This temperature will melt the turbine. Okay. This high temperature in the combustion chamber will melt the turbine. The blade of the turbine will be melted. So this, the another function of this oil, to cool the turbine blade. Okay? This and to keep the exhaust gas temperature in the normal range. Do you have question?
You mean this oil or
the oil. We mixed oil with a specific ratio with the fuel itself. So it will go using the gear pump. Here we have a gear pump. It will suck the fuel and it will send it to the combustion chamber. Okay?
So what he's saying is the fuel is used for heating the air by combustion and also for cooling the engine. Because it is at lower temperature than the engine, so it will be able to absorb some heat from the engine. Okay, so it has two purposes, cooling as well as, it's interested in cooling and also heating.
Okay. Anyone have a question? Just take a look to this jet engine, try to know where is the sensors, where is the thermocouples, where is the pressure sensor, where is the load cell, where is the tachometer. Take a look and try to look inside to see the compressor and everything.
Can you bring this sensor?